Just about 20 minutes to 8 now, and coming up, a Christmas story for any family. We'll meet the author.
You know, Christmas is a time to get together with family, to remember the good old days, as we call them, and share stories of love and hope. The book, The Golden Ring, is one man's tribute to his own family's Christmas memories, and has become a holiday bestseller. John Snyder is the author, and he joins us this morning. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you this morning?
I'm doing great. So this book, The Golden Ring, was inspired by your grandmother.
Yes, it was. We were sitting at her kitchen table just a few days after Christmas, drinking coffee and eating leftover Christmas cookies, and I asked her what your most precious Christmas memory was, and she related this story to me, and then it I originally started writing it for my own family, and then it kind of evolved into a book. It's based on her story, but we added some things and elaborated a little bit.
I was intrigued by the fact that you actually went back to the town where this story took place, and you know, went to where the house once stood, and you know, just really got the feel of what it was like.
Yeah, well, after she told me the story, I remember my great-grandmother, and I remember going to her house as a child and had fond memories. So I decided to drive up to that town. It was a couple hours away. And when I got there, I went to the address, and of course, there was a vacant lot. The house had been torn down. But I could stand there and imagine. There's a little bit of snow in the air, and I could imagine just what went on in that house that many years ago.
The story, though, while it's a wonderful Christmas tale, it does have a meaning. It does have a lesson in it, doesn't it?
Yes, my grandmother and her father had a really close relationship, and they started sharing these common dreams about the giving and receiving of a ring. And they sort of went on a journey to find the meaning to these dreams, and really it led them to the real meaning of Christmas and a lot closer relationship between the two of them.
What a wonderful, wonderful way to you know, share your story, your family story with folks, but to also share the true meaning of Christmas. It's through, I guess, as we grow up, we tend to learn more and more about the true meaning.
Yeah, we do, and I think we get a little more sentimental as we get older. And I like older people's stories, because if you don't ask them the stories about their youth, when they pass on, you lose all that. And I think that, you know, we have an obligation to kind of keep these things going.
Oh, I totally agree. Did you have to do a lot of research about the time period that you wrote this from?
Yes, I did. But my grandmother was my technical advisor. I just called her and said, did you have electricity? Did you, you know?
That's great. That's wonderful. Well, I tell you what, it is a great story. And you have two opportunities to meet John and get a copy of his book signed. Tomorrow, he will be at the gift shop inside Wake Forest University Baptist Medical Center. And then on Saturday, he'll be in Greensboro at the Borders Bookstore on High Point Road. The event runs noon to 4 p.m. Thanks so much for coming.
Thank you for having me.
Appreciate it.